Hey, what's up guys? Today we're gonna be checking out the Mark Rober 40 mile per hour blanket. Now you know I've got a lot of fun gadgets and toys like electric scooters and drones that I'm gonna go put this thing to the test. Go racing by it, see how it works, and I've even got a speed gun here, so we're gonna cross compare, check the accuracy of this blanket. So I'm Ben Schmanke from AuthenTech, and let's jump into it. All right, first let's get this thing unwrapped. I purchased this blanket myself. It goes for about 89 bucks, so it's not cheap, but you're supporting Mark Rober and all of his content creation. Here's the little instruction sheet that comes with it. Basically, each square is very precise, and then we pop our camera, our iPhone, into slow-mo, 240 FPS, it's 1 mile per hour per frame. If you want kilometers across the pond, just multiply 1.6. First, let's check out the blanket. And I like that back blue side. It's soft. You can actually use it like a blanket if you wanted, or hang it up as a chroma key tool, which is really neat as well. Here is the size. This is pretty big. You can see in relation to this couch. Could use it for magic tricks. It's nice. All right, let's go zipping by with some fast things and check its speed. All right, I've got lots of drones, but I think one of my fastest ones is the X-Night. Check. I'd say one of the stumbling blocks that I thought of is hanging this thing up. And if I had friends, that'd be nice. They could hold it up for me, but I don't have that. I can maybe do a C-stand, but that's sort of big and bulky and heavy. But thankfully, Mark included these nice little hoops on each end. So I'm thinking I'm gonna use just a little bit of some Atwood rope and tie it between two objects and see if that works. If these hoops were a little bit bigger, maybe that'd be nice. All right, one side down. I'm not sure how much I'm gonna need, so I'll just pull off quite a bit and then snip it. All right, I've got strings now on the top corners. Let's go out and try a few samples. And it's pretty lightweight, portable. All right, first location, let's try the back fence.
Is it a racetrack, Papa?
Isn't that cool?
Is it a hunting track?
Okay, ready? You help me. All right, go run by it. Go, go, go. Okay.
Jed was 8 and you were 11.
So right here brings up possibly the biggest issue with the speed marker system. If my object is even off the blanket just a few feet, and then depending on the camera lens that we use from the primary or the ultra wide, we're gonna run into a parallax issue. Now unfortunately, I could not find Mark Rober bringing attention to this on his website or the instructions, and I noticed after the fact that in his video samples, like the Nerf dart, he tries to stick up as tight against the blanket, and it's probably for this exact reason. And basically, since I didn't realize this until later, basically all my objects were off axis from the blanket quite a bit, so they're pretty inaccurate, but now we know, I guess.
You were 11, Jed was 7.
Next sample, got a little wiffle ball. Let's check it and see how fast it goes.
41.
41?
Yeah.
Oh, sweet. Check it out. So we go back into the slow-mo, and then as the ball passes, see the ball pass through frame?
Uh-huh.
55 starts right here. Maybe I have to do another one because it's not on a full frame. I got some help from Destin from Smarter Every Day with this math. If the object travels across the blanket faster than 40 miles per hour or in less than 1 second in 240 FPS, then I count the frames it takes to cross. So this ball, for example, takes 21 frames. So we take 30 divided by 21, that equals 1.428, then multiply by 40 miles per hour, and the speed would approximately be 57 miles per hour. Now that's if the object was on that same focal plane as the blanket, which sadly it's not, so even this number is slightly off. All right, now let's change up location. It's getting cool, I can just wrap the rope around a couple times and that holds it up since the blanket's not too heavy. That looks cool, huh? There we go, that's pretty nice. Let's try the Apollo first, this thing's fun. Turbo on. All right, next we're gonna pull out the Dualtron Storm. This beast, they say, can go over 50 miles per hour. Now the blanket's only 40, so that's a safe excuse for me to not go that fast. But let's get a helmet, and let's set up the blanket and go for a couple runs. Make sure you check out my full review on this Dualtron after this video. All right, I found the perfect spot, open field, no one around. Got a nice baseball backstop, chain link. I'm gonna race from this direction, right by. and then plenty of braking room. Well, should be enough. All right, packs into the bag, nice and easy. Here we go, they make orientation pretty simple. All the text is upright in only one direction. Seems like a fun gift you could just maybe give to a friend or maybe a kid. I know when I was a kid, I would have loved to see how fast I could throw a baseball or kick a soccer ball, and speed guns are hundreds of dollars. Okay, well, I guess this thing's $100, but all right, now let's set up. We switch this camera over into slow-mo, 240 FPS. I'm gonna go racing by. Says I was going by 21. Now, I will say, playing back and trying to get one exact second on that timeline in the iPhone player, and then while counting the squares, it's a little difficult. Of course, if you're just a kid and having fun, it doesn't need to be that precise. All right, we're at location number two. Got the blanket set up, got the FPV drone, DJI Digital for the win. We're gonna go zoom, flying by and check the speed. This should be good. So in the end, is it super accurate and precise? Well, I don't think so, not really. Is it supposed to be? I'm not sure, you'd have to ask Mark that. But honestly, in order to get those planes matched up perfectly for an accurate reading, and it's gonna be a little bit tricky for most objects. In the end, I think it's just more of a fun thing to experiment with. And honestly, my favorite part was playing with my boy and throwing balls and running past it. And I know when he gets older, I'll be able to teach him some of the fun math and sciences behind it all. And if you're looking for an accurate, precise reading, well, then get a radar gun. I reviewed this one a couple years ago. You can check out that video. Other speed guns are on Amazon for like $100. What's cool about the blanket is you have that blue screen on the back. So as a young filmmaker, you can learn about chroma keying and do those Zach King magic tricks, which is really fun to play with as well. And of course, it's an easy way to support the content creator, you know, give a little bit money back to him for all those fun and educational videos that he makes. Oh, and it's a pretty soft and cozy blanket as well, so there's that. If you want to learn more about my FPV drones or that electric scooter that goes crazy fast, I'll give you those links down below. Thanks guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Perfect durability test. We hit the blanket with the prop and doesn't look like any bad damage. Nice.